ومن سلك طريقا يلتمس فيه علما سهل الله له به طريقا إلى الجنة.
I was going to ask as well, if you feel like you're taking too many classes as well, is there any aib in like dropping one or two to make sure that the rest are like you're doing muraja and stuff like that? And is in you're maintaining your muraja because you feel as if you're not able to give each one its fair, if that makes sense?
It makes sense, but if you're really truly dividing your times fairly, not sacrificing dars for 1 hour sometime for chit-chat. You know what Sheikh Albani used to do? Not to give up time. The door that opens that way, he changed the hinge to open the other way that saves him a few seconds. But he was not sacrificing the talab al-ilm. Think about your time. If you wallahi organize your time, believe me, you would make everything. If you organize your time properly, check how many hours or you have, how many minutes that you have a day that it's wasted. Don't tell me you don't have.
Everyone has wasted time.
Exactly. So organize the wasted time rather than sacrificing the lesson time. Don't you agree? Do you know what Shaykh Abdullah Hudayya is saying? So if Talib al-Ilm does not study 16 hours a day, then he's not a Talib al-Ilm. Yes. They were living life of Salaf, truly life of Salaf, where they were used to put bread in a water and do that and drink it. Save you time of cooking and cleaning pots and all these things. Salaf, they used to do that. Yeah, we don't do that, but I'm sure we have a lot of spare times that we waste. We do. And only shaitan, it's the only gate of door of shaitan that comes to you. Tells you, oh, you're really overdoing yourself. Really, it's too much. No. You know, drop two of them. Then if you find you more excuse, to drop the other one as well. Have no doubt about that. Only the things that benefit you, shaitan will fight you. You know, every week, before I come here, I am in such a great pain, you don't understand. Instead of I drop it, I take extra painkiller. Every week I become, the night I would not be able to sleep, and in the morning all my body is hurting. Ask Ismail. And real sickness. This is the things that benefit you, shaitan want to fight you. The things that does not benefit your akhirah, shaitan will never fight you. It's up to you, akhi. Barakallahu fikum. If it's up to me, we'll have lesson every day, 7 days a week. That's how you learn ilm. Sheikh Ibn Uthaymeen used to have 6-7 days a week. He used to refuse going to countries, to others. You know, he never been out of Saudi. The only place he went for ilaj is America for treatment. Yeah, for treatment. And when they told him you have to have a chemotherapy, and you lose your hair, he said, I don't want to face Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala hairless. He refused. He came back. He never been out of Saudi. Just because of focus in masjid with his talaba and a dars. Having 2-3 dars a day for 6-7 days a week. That's how they learned. Allah understand.
The way this country is made, distraction a lot.
Exactly, distraction. Why?
Not over there, people go to Saudi. Their main focus is just
studying. What are you talking about? No, they were working. They were all working. I'm working. They were working. Yeah, you can make time for it. You can make time for it. Take the time. Take 9 hours you sleep and make a 7. You know, in Arab they say, "Man talab al-ula sahar al-layali." You wanna reach the peak of the mountain, you have to stay awake at night. Sahar al-layali, man talab al-ula. So it's your choice. But remember, we have a habit. For example, how many dars you have a week? Yes.
Maybe about 6 or 7.
1 hour each, right?
First.
8 hours, say. 10 hours, say, yeah? Out of 124 hours a week, you study 10 hours for Islam. Study 10 hours. And you want to see really sacrifice that as well? Huh? 7 days a week is 124 hours. You study 10 hours maximum. You still want to sacrifice that out of the other 114 hours that you have? You know, willing to sacrifice things from there? This is where you are. This is who you are. We think that shaitan is dangerous. You think like, I do enough. It's like, I'm doing it. It's like you are, subhanAllah, doing favor to Allah, subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's for you. You get closer to Him. You know? This is this position is not for everyone. Many people we know, they were tulab ilm from time of Sahabi. I give you example of the Ansari and Ibn Abbas, where all the Sahabis were there, where they both start seeking knowledge. Where he stopped, he said all the kibar Sahaba were there. Ibn Abbas continued learning and learning. He went to do business, and when all the kibar Sahaba died, Ibn Abbas sat jalasa mutarabbi'an ala kursi al-fatwa. He sat on the chair of fatwa, where people all over the world, they used to come to his door. He said, I remember what I lost then. Allahu alam. Barakallahu fikum.